Thank you for everyone who has given a testimony or shared.
我们感谢每一位今天上来为大家做见证的弟兄姊妹。
It is a wonderful reminder for all of us that God is always working in our midst.
这是对我们神在我们生命当中每个人都在做工的一个何等奇妙的提醒。
This morning I want to bridge from our church theme for the past 2 years into our new church theme for the next year to come.
今天早上我想在这里把我们过去两年来追求的主题和我们将要追求的明年的主题做一个连结。
And to do this, I want to look at Hebrews chapter 10.
我们一起来看希伯来书第十章。
Starting in verse 19,
从第十九节开始。
Therefore, brothers, since we have confidence to enter the holy places by the blood of Jesus,
弟兄们，我们既因耶稣的血得以坦然进入至圣所。
By the new and living way that he opened for us through the curtain, that is through his flesh.
是借着他给我们开了一条又新又活的路，从幔子经过，这幔子就是他的身体。
And since we have a great priest over the house of God,
又有一位大祭司治理神的家。
The writer of Hebrews is grounding us in our status before God.
希伯来书的作者是在这里再次强调我们在耶稣基督里所有的地位。
Grounding us in who we are in Jesus.
在提醒我们在耶稣基督里面我们所是的。
We have salvation because of what Christ has accomplished for us.
我们之所以有这样的救恩，是因为耶稣基督在十字架上为我们做成的。
Now, because of that, verse 22.
因为这样，在二十二节里面
，He gives three commands.
他给了我们三个训练诫命。
And in the English, they are three "let us" commands.
在英文里面，我们可以翻成让我们一起。
So the first one in verse 22.
所以第一个是在二十二节里面。
Let us draw near with a true heart in full assurance of faith, with our hearts sprinkled clean from an evil conscience, and with our bodies washed with pure water.
并我们心中天良的亏欠已经洒去，身体用清水洗净了，就当存着诚心和充足的信心来到神面前。
I feel that this is a good summary of what we've been talking about for the past 2 years.
这我觉得是一个对我们过去两年来所讲论的一个很好的总结。
Through the pandemic, what was the thing that we most needed?
在这个疫情当中，我们所需要的最大的一件事情是什么？
It was to be built up.
我们是要被建造。
It was to be edified.
是要被建立。
It was to draw close to Jesus.
是要来到神耶稣面前。
And so, for the past 2 years, we have been focusing in on drawing closer to the source of our salvation.
所以我们过去两年是在如何来在这个救恩的源头上，我们更加来到他的面前，更加接近他。
And praise God, God has been doing that in our midst.
赞美神啊，神在这样我们当中正在做着这样一件事。
Through not only the messages on Sunday,
不单是在主日的信息当中
，but even through the testimonies that we have just heard.
也在我们刚才所听到的所有一切人的见证当中。
We have drawn close to God.
我们就近神更加近了。
But we don't want to stop there.
但是我们并不要仅止于此。
Just like when we're sick, we want to eat and recover our strength.
就像我们在生病的时候，我们要好好的吃饮食我们就可以康复。
Part of that recovery is not just eating and drinking and being and recovering our strength.
那个康复的过程并不仅仅止于好好的饮食吃喝。
But then it's also using that energy and that health to do things.
而且要用我们的健康和能力去做一些其他的事情。
And so I feel that now as we have, it's been a few years since the worst of the pandemic.
现在我们看到我们经历了疫情最糟糕的时期已经过了，已经有两三年了。
And in those horrible times, we've been focusing in on ourselves.
在那些可怕的时间里面，我们可能是关注在我们自己身上。
Drawing close to the Lord.
我们要更近的来到主面前。
So now Hebrews has two more things for us to do as we continue in our growth as believers.
所以希伯来书在这里有另外两件事要我们在成长的当中要做的。
Verse
23,
let us hold fast the confession of our hope without wavering, for he who promised is faithful.
也要坚守我们所承认的指望，不致摇动，因为那应许我们的是信实的。
This command commands us to not only hold what we have built up, but also move forward.
这个诫命是要我们不但的持守我们所已有的，也要我们在这个已有的基础上继续的往前走。
To be strong not only in our faith, but also to look forward to the glory that is to come.
我们不但要在我们的信心里面要坚守坚强，我们也要在前面更荣耀的事上有这样的盼望。
So the first point is, let us hold fast.
所以第一个点就是要我们能够坚守，或者说我们能够持定。
This speaks of endurance.
这讲的是我们的忍耐。
This speaks of persevering, like running a race.
这也讲到的是我们的坚忍，就像一个赛跑一样。
Racers prepare for a race, they get strong.
所以你要为了这个比赛，你要把自己练得更加强壮。
But the race is not finished until they reach the end.
当然，这个比赛直到你到终点是不会结束的。
And so Hebrews encourages us as we have drawn close to the Lord. Now we need to take that and look forward to the ending line.
所以希伯来书在这里提醒我们，我们要持守我们所有的。然后向前看到我们所要奔跑的那个终点。
And secondly, in verse 24,
在第二点，在二十四节。
And let us consider how to stir up one another in love and good works.
又要彼此相顾，激发爱心，勉励行善。
Let us consider.
要我们彼此相顾。
That is.Be thinking about something.
就是要我们要思想一件事情。
What is to be on our minds?
我们在头脑里面，我们都在想些什么。
Hebrews says to stir up one another.
希伯来书说要激发彼此的激发。
Now that word "stir up" is a very interesting word.
激发这个字在这里是很有意味的。
That word in the original Greek means to irritate.
在原文的希腊文里面，它有触怒的意思。
Or to provoke.
或有挑动的意思。
Usually we would use this word in terms of someone making us angry.
我们通常用这个字是用在一个人想叫别人触动别人发怒的情况下。
And in the same way,People can very easily make us angry.
同样的方式，别人也可以让我们很生气。
Hebrews says we should be making one another better at loving and doing good deeds.
希伯来书在这里确实说，要我们在彼此要激发在行善的上面，在爱心上面要做得更好。
And how do we do that?
我们如何才能做到呢?
Verse 25.
第二十五节。
Not neglecting to meet together, as is the habit of some, but encouraging one another, and all the more as you see the day drawing near.
你们不可停止聚会，好像那些停止惯了的人，倒要彼此劝勉，既知道那日子临近，就更当如此。
So the first way that we provoke one another, stir one another up to loving good deeds is this.
所以我们彼此激发爱心的方式是这样。
We meet together.
我们要彼此相会，在聚会当中彼此见面。
How does salt make food flavorful?
盐怎样使食物变得有味道呢？
It must be touching the meat.
这个盐必须放在这个肉上面。
And so in the same way, in order to encourage one another to be more loving and do good deeds, we need to be meeting together.
所以为了要激发爱心，勉励善行，我们必须要在聚会当中彼此见面。
It is impossible to obey this command without meeting together as a church.
如果我们彼此在聚会当中都见不了面，我们是没有办法遵行这个诫命的。
Or meeting in our fellowships.
在我们的团契当中彼此相见。
If we have no point in contact, we cannot fulfill this command.
我们如果没有彼此的接触，我们是没有办法遵行这个诫命。
The other way is that we all the more as we see the day approaching.
另外一个点就是当我们看到那个日子临近了。
We do this together and we also do this with a sense of urgency.
我们同时也做这件事情是有一种紧迫感。
For indeed, the day that Jesus returned is closer now than it ever was before.
耶稣再来的日子就现在来讲比以往任何的时间更加近了。
And so this is our theme for the next year.
所以这就是我们明年所追求的主题。
That we stir one another up.
所以我们要彼此激励。
And I mean, sorry, that we hold fast.
我们要持定。
And that we stir one another up to love and good deeds.
我们要持定，然后要彼此相顾，持定盼望。
So let me pray for us.
所以我们一起来为我们祷告。
Heavenly Father, we thank you for being with us.
天上的父，我们感谢你，因为你与我们同在。
We have seen this fact through the testimonies that we have heard.
我们在所有人的见证当中都见到了，都听到了这样的事实。
We thank you that even in the midst of a global pandemic, you have helped us to draw close to you.
甚至即使是在全世界的疫情当中，你也让我们与你靠得更近。
And Lord, as we come into a new year, we pray, Lord, that you continue to do that good work in us.
主，当我们迎接新的一年的时候，求你在继续在我们当中做这样的工作。
For you are the author of our faith.
因为你是我们信心创始成终的救主。
You are the one who originated our salvation.
你是创立了我们的救恩。
So as you who started a good work in us, Lord, bring it to completion.
你既然开启了这样的善工，你必要成就。
And we pray, Lord, that the year coming up would be a year for growth.
所以当我们来到迎接新的一年的时候，我们盼望这样是一个成长的一年。
Not just recovering from a global pandemic, but a year of health and growth and maturity.
不仅是从疫情当中恢复过来，也是一个健康、生长、成熟的一年。
Help us to hold firm to our faith.
帮助我们能够持定我们的信仰。
Looking to the glory that you have bought for us on the cross.
仰望你在十字架上为我们所成就的这个荣耀的救恩。
And to always be thinking about how to stir one another up in good deeds and in love.
总要在彼此之间彼此激励。
And we pray.
勉励善行。
And we pray in Jesus' name.
我们奉主耶稣基督的名。
Amen.
Amen.